A common question regarding Testlab is how to import and export data between Testlab and Excel. Let's look at how to export data from Testlab first. One way to export data is to plot the data, then right-click on the data, say copy values, and then all. If you open Excel and paste, the data will be pasted into Excel. You can see that the first few dozen rows contain header information, which contains data about weighting, data type, timestamps, etc. This is to preserve information about the data even if it's moved between Testlab and Excel. Below the header information, we have our actual numerical data. I'll save the Excel file and then go back into LMS Testlab. To import Excel data into Testlab, go to Tools, Add-ins, and turn on the Excel data driver. After you ensure that your Excel data driver is turned on, browse to the location where you saved the Excel file, open the Excel file, and select the sheet which will contain your data block. Drop it into a front-back, and you'll see that the data that you import is exactly the same as the exported data. Now imagine that you've got multiple curves that you want to import. In this case, I'll drop a few extra auto powers into my plot, select them all, copy all of the values again. Now when I open Excel and paste the values in, you can see that I've got the header information for all of my curves, followed by the numerical data for all of my curves. Another alternative could be copying a limited frequency range. I'll remove some of my curves so that you can see the concept demonstrated on just one curve. If I narrow in on my frequency range, and then I select my values between X limits, when I copy this into Excel, now after the header information, I only get the limited frequency range, in this case starting at 600 Hz and going to 900 Hz. Now imagine you have some Excel data that you didn't originally export from Testlab. Let's take a look at that example. This sheet, Import Me, contains frequency and pressure data, but does not have valuable header information such as data type, frequency resolution, or sample rate. Because it's missing some of the valuable header information, Testlab doesn't automatically recognize it like it recognized our other block that we previously exported. If you don't know exactly what kind of header information is required for Testlab to import the data, then I would recommend using the Data Block Editor instead. The Data Block Editor will guide you through filling out the required header information so that you can import your data into Testlab. To access the Data Block Editor, go to Tools, Add-ins, and turn on the Data Block Editor add-in. Again, this requires no additional tokens or extra licensing. It's part of the Testlab desktop. Once you have the Data Block Editor turned on, go through the different pieces of header information at the top so that you can properly import your data. In this case, like I said at the beginning, we're importing an auto power in the linear format, and this auto power is of pressure data. The format is peak. I'll enter the number of lines that I need to insert. I'll give it a point ID. And then I simply copy and paste my data from Excel. The plot populates with the data that I just pasted, and you can see that the data is appropriate for what I was trying to import. To save the data into your project, hit Add to Workspace, and then click Save Workspace in Active Project. Select the location where you want to save your data, or create a new folder, and then save your data in that location. When you go back to the Navigator, open the folder where you saved your data, and you'll be able to plot whatever you just imported.